Words of wisdom for the newlyweds is never forget the main purpose why you got married. No matter how rough and tough it gets, there was a reason that attracted each other and why you said I do.
I can only imagine.
Congratulations, I know you guys are meant for each other. I know you guys will be so happy for each other.
When I walk by your side, I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me.
Bite your tongue.
She's always right.
You okay with being late for everything?
Good luck and blah. God bless you all.
That's God first.
Good luck, pray together, and that will get you far.
Have fun.
Congratulations on getting married.
Don't go to bed angry, and you won't wake up angry. Love each other, and help each other.
Be strong. Love her.
You two, be nice to each other, and just remember that you wanted this, and I hope you lots of peace, and I hope everything works out for you, and you're real happy with each other, and then that you grow old, and together make lots of good memories.
If I speak in the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy, and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away.
What's
the renowned part,
the
prophecy in the part. When perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see a poor reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
So slowly, and time can do so much. Are you still more? I need your love. I need your love. God, speed your love to me. Lonely rivers flow to the sea, to the open arms of the sea. Wait for me, I'll be coming home.
Hold on, fun. This is fantastic. Welcome, everyone. I'm going to say today is the day the Lord has made, and if you agree with me, your response is, let us rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Darcy and Michael, will you, as you're looking at each other right now, will you turn and look at your friends and family that are here? This is a good-looking bunch of folks right here, isn't it? So take a good long look at these friends. who have already stood alongside you, that your family has carried you from the beginning. We are all still here, and we will continue to be so. We represent not only your friends and family, but right now in this moment, we represent God's church to you and to each other. Gathered together today to participate in what God is doing in our midst, because no marriage should be left to itself, left on its own to figure it out. You will need your friends and family. You will need the church. So it is not only the two of you who are making commitments here today, it is also your friends and family representing the church that will be making their own commitments of support and encouragement. And so it's with that in mind, I'll ask all of y'all, the friends and family of Michael and Darcy, will you all, as witnesses to the vows soon to be made by these two lovebirds, vow to care for and encourage, laugh with, party with, cry with, and hold the hands of Michael and Darcy as they enter into this new country called marriage? If so, the response is, we will.
We will.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I would do is forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Sing hallelujah. Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine.
Let's pray. God, thank you for the gift of glimpses of heaven. And thank you that in Scripture the most often image of heaven isn't clouds or harps or any of that, but it's a wedding feast with you. And so here at this particular wedding feast, we remember not only the love of Michael and Darcy, but also your love for us. That knits us all together. Thank you so much for the gift of today and for the love of Michael and Darcy. Amen. Michael and Darcy, you both know a lot about what life is like when it doesn't go the way it's supposed to. And we're all so excited to be here today on a day when we're all so delighted and we're all so happy and we're all in such a good mood. And I wanted this particular scripture read because that love that sustains us in the hard and the broken places is sustained by a God that knows what brokenness is like, because Jesus himself was broken. And so my hope and my prayer for you is that you'll continue to lean into Jesus in the times when it's hard. In the times when it's broken. Yeah, well, I want to sit next to that person while I'm eating. Who we choose to eat with and when we choose to eat them will shape your marriage tremendously, just as all the other things that you decide as a marriage together will shape who you are. We are so excited for y'all. We are so proud of y'all. And may y'all continue to lean into recovery, lean into Jesus, lean into the church, as you walk through this new beautiful place called marriage. Darcy and Michael, as you stand here now and always in the presence of God of love, and having carefully considered the holy covenant you are about to make, you are making promises to one another that are sacred, unconditional, and lifelong. Will you now publicly pledge your faithfulness to one another with the vows you are about to make and exchange rings as symbol of these vows? If so, you say, we will.
We will.
We will.
Do we have any rings? Michael, before God and these witnesses, do you take Darcy to be your wife, to live together as one flesh? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, support her in recovery, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful only to her so long as you both shall live? So say, I do.
I do.
And give her the ring. It's all right. She'll finish the last. No call on her. Darcy, before God and these witnesses, do you take Michael to be your husband, to live together as one flesh? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, support him in recovery, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful only to him so long as you both shall live?
Okay.
If so, say, I do. Give him his ring.
That's sweet.
And now, it is my great joy to pronounce you husband and wife.
I can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine.
Having pledged your faith in and love for Jesus and each other, and having sealed your marriage vows by the giving and receiving these rings, therefore, in the presence of the living God and these your witnesses, I now pronounce you husband and wife, in the name of the Father,
only
and the Son,
imagine,
and the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no one tear us apart.
When I walk,
that was fun.
My part's done, so.
Are you gonna introduce them?
This is Michael and Darcy.
I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, one will my heart feel when I dance.
So my dad has been through some hard times and some good times, but all the good times was with us. And now that she is married, we'll carry those good times and we'll pass them on to the relatives of our family members. So when she goes to heaven, her love for Michael will too. Amen.
Nice,
can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my